I promise to officiate the games with complete impartiality and follow the principles of fair play. But not always. Hello and thank you for being with me. I am Alex Krumer and I'm an economist who likes to use sports data to study things beyond sports. As usual, I will try to make it straight and to the point. In my last video, I showed you different biases in decision making. Today, I will provide several examples on referees' systematic biases in professional sports that are driven by favoritism.
Get set!
Favoritism is defined as the practice of giving unfair preferential treatment to one person or group at the expense of another. Not something we would like to see in sport. The most common bias in sports relates to the well-known home advantage, according to which referees are biased in favor of the home team. For example, one study showed that football referees systematically favored home teams by adding significantly more extra time at the end of the game if the home team was losing by one goal, compared to the case when the home team was leading by one goal. Another study showed that crowd noise had a significant effect on the probability of a referee issuing a yellow card against the home team. Consequently, the absence of crowds during COVID-19 restrictions was probably the main reason for the reduced home advantage in many leagues. If a home team bias is, let's say, somewhat acceptable, the other types of biases are absolutely unacceptable. I'm talking about in-group favoritism that is driven by similarities between the referee and some of the competitors. In reality, many different features can create group identities, such as nationality, language, or skin color, all of which can result in biased decision-making. For example, according to nationalistic bias, referees favor their compatriots. This bias has been found in figure skating, dressage competitions, and ski jumping. Moreover, in ski jumping competitions, the size of the bias is correlated with the corruption perceptions index of the country. For example, the largest nationalistic bias was observed among judges from Russia. However, the only two countries whose judges did not favor their compatriots were Finland and Norway. Another study investigated linguistic bias in Switzerland, a country with four official languages. The study finds that football referees assign significantly more yellow and red cards against teams from a different linguistic area, compared to teams that share the same linguistic area with the referee. So if differences in language is an issue in a country like Switzerland, then this is a particular concern in less prosperous countries where linguistic differences may even be associated with the likelihood of ethnic civil war. Another study showed that NBA players have fewer fouls called against them and score more points when their race was similar to that of the refereeing crew. This and previous findings are driven by the implicit discrimination that may arise due to the unconscious association of a social group with one or more negative attributes. Such an unconscious association may play a role in the type of split-second, high-pressure situations that appear in sports competitions. As evidence, one study used MRI images of brain activities. It showed that participants reacted differently to pictures of people from a different race compared to pictures of people from their own race. The results on systematic bias of referees are important because awareness can be of great value. This is because a proper feedback training to judges may reduce the bias. As evidence, in a follow-up study on racial discrimination in the NBA, the researchers showed that the racial bias among NBA referees disappeared after widespread media coverage. So maybe sport can make the world a better place. I hope you liked this video. All the references to the mentioned studies in the video appear in the description. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. Likes and comments are there, and they are more than welcome. I hope to see you soon.